Okay, guys, I'm going to do something very different today. I'm going to do create a bot in 3commas. Okay, so to do this, you need to connect 3commas to Binance via an API so that it can interact with trading and stuff like that. The first thing I do, so I'm going to create a DCA bot, which is dollar cost average bot. Okay. And rather than gold, guard and multi-pair, you click on advanced. Okay. And I'm going to give it a description. So I'm going to trade coti. I've actually got one set up already, but I'm going to set up a new one with some different parameters. So let's get this right. Coti BUSD, long bot. And what I do when I'm doing a creating a bot, I give it a description which has the settings. So you can give it quite a long description. And okay, so that's good enough for me. Okay. I'll explain more about that, those kind of description better. So you come down here and you click on pairs. It sounds a bit tricky, this. What is going on here? Why won't it let me? Seems to have crashed. Right, hold on a minute. What is going on here? I'm clicking in the wrong bit. What is going on? Right, here we go. So you type in coti, and I'm doing BUSD bot. So that one. Okay, so coti. And you'll notice up here, I've got my balance, so I've got $3,000 BUSD. And at the moment, if I have the bot set up the way it's set up at the moment, it's going to cost me $61 to run it. Okay, so let's come down. Strategy, it's long. Okay, so I'm not shorting it, it's a long bot. Profit currency. So if you quote BUSD, so if you leave it here, you can change it here like this. If you leave it on that one, that means you'll take profit in BUSD. Okay. If you want, you can take the profit in coti. So in other words, you can increase your amount of cryptocurrency. Now, base order size. So I'm going to have it as 35. Okay. Now, if you watch this number go up, whoops. If I put it back to 10, you'll see the number go down. Okay, 61. So if we put it up to 35, you'll notice the number go up. Okay. And then the safety order size, I'm going to put as 80. And now you see it massively go up. Okay. So it's costing me more to run this bot. Okay, which is fine. Don't worry about it. Now, start order, you want limit orders. Now, you want limit orders because then you won't be paying fees, okay, unless you do make the bot start as soon as possible. If you click on the limit, or okay, rather than market, you'll get limit orders. So limit orders are free if you're using BUSD. So I just click a few of these and I take off that one. So I don't want open new trade as soon as possible. You can have that on if you want. I mean, to be honest with you, it's fine to do that. And I'm going to take off the 1 minute one and I'm just going to leave those three on. But again, you can add other things in here. Okay. Other things that you can do, for instance, which I'm not going to bother do, for instance, you can, let me just give it some more room. So for instance, you can change the RSI. So for instance, only buy if it's below 70, for instance, you can change the number 65. Whatever, I'm not going to bother with that, but you can have that on. Target profit, so I'm just going to get 1.2% profit on my trades. So as soon as it's made 1.2% profit, it's going to sell, and then it'll start buying again, okay? So I'm going to take a profit of 1.2%. safety orders, okay? So this is the amount of trades. How can I put it? All right, okay, I'll explain in a graph. So at the moment, it's set at 5. So if I go to the table, okay? So basically, what it's going to do is it's going to buy, okay, and then it's going to buy some more. So if the price goes down, it'll buy some more to dollar cost average down. So that's what it does effectively. So it buys at 35. Next one it'll buy at is 80. It'll buy another one at 80, 80, 80, and so on. Okay. So if it goes down a certain amount, it'll keep buying to dollar cost average down. So if you imagine a graph, actually, have I actually got a graph? You don't even actually have a graph. You need to have a graph. Okay, so US dollar amount, it should be USD, but so safety orders, it's up to there, and that's how much I'm going to spend, basically. So I actually want this up higher. Let's just go back to that. So maximum safety order price deviation, 5%. So in other words, if it drops 5%, okay, if I had this set up as is, as soon as it's dropping 5%, then that's it, it won't buy anymore because I haven't set anything up, okay? So that's no good because we know in crypto land, a drop of 5%, that happens in 5 minutes, okay? So I want it bigger than that. So I'm going to put it up to sort of 13, let's see. So if you put it to 13, now it goes up to $1,000, okay? That's okay. And then what I'm going to do is a price deviation. So each safety order price deviation. So I'm going to put it up to 2. And now you see it's up to 26%. So basically, if it deviates by 26%, I'm still going to be buying coti. Okay, up to 26%. If it falls through 26%, it won't buy anymore. Okay, I'll just be stuck with a bag of coti that's gone from up here down to here, fallen 26%. Okay, and I won't be able to buy anymore. So what I need it then to happen is to go up a tiny bit. Okay, because it's dollar cost average down, it'll only have to go up, say, 6% from that point, let's say, for argument's sake, to then sell it all. Okay, so that's kind of how the DCA bots work. Ideally, you want these, to be honest with you, stuff like 30 and 2. So you can afford a 60% deviation. So if it falls 60%, okay, and that's straight down, by the way. If it comes straight down and doesn't go up high enough to sell your coins, then you'll be stuck with it. It goes straight down, okay? But if you don't mind being stuck with it, so being stuck with coti, I'm okay with, let's say. Now, if you're stuck with something like Shiba Inu, that might be a different story because it's a shit coin, okay? So you don't mind being stuck with Bitcoin because you know it's going to go up in the end. You don't mind being stuck with Solana because you know it's going to go up in the end. Ethereum, you know it's going to go up. Okay, so I've already set up bots with those coins already, but I'm just showing you how to do it on these. So I'm going to bring that down to 13, have it 2. So I've got a 26%. So if it does go down 26, it's going to cost me $1,000. Okay, and that's fine. Most of the time, it's going to be going through 2 safety orders, okay, or 2 or 3 safety orders, and then it'll eventually sell. It doesn't get up to 13 very often, especially at the moment. Remember, we're in a bull market, okay? So it's fine. We're in a bull market. And the safety order volume scale, so that's going to make it go up a little bit more, okay? So you look at the chart, it's slightly, changes each time with the things. Okay, so that's basically my settings for a bot. I mean, you can change the profits. So for instance, you can take it down, you put it down, say 0.8, for instance. Okay, that's not going to change any of these settings, but it will adjust your table. Actually, it won't adjust your table, but what it'll mean is you'll get 0.8% of, say, that one, if it sells, 0.8% of that price there, okay? So I'm going to have it at 1.2, okay? A lot of people put it at, say, 1. Don't put it at something like 3, okay? And another thing I don't like is trailing, okay? Trailing, what that does is if it's going straight up, So it can be good. If it goes straight up, you can get all percentage gains, okay, in one kind of order. So if it goes up 6%, you can get all the 6%, and it kind of comes back like 0.2 back or something or other. Okay, so, but don't bother with, I don't like trailing. It's up to you if you want to put it on. But I'm happy with that. So all I've got to do now is create bot. So I'm happy with those. And then start. Okay, so the bot is turned on. So if I go to, so these are all the settings, just going over, bot is turned on, start command is received. So you'll get all these, this will start filling up over time. Okay, so if we go back to my other bots. So my bots, if I go to my enable bots, I've just got 5 bots on at the moment. In the past, I've had a ridiculous amount of bots running, okay? But if I was you, if you're starting off, just start off with only a few bots. I've just decided just to go back and started trading bots, with doing bots as well. So I'll do normal trading, day trading and stuff, but I'm also going to use bots as well. I've just decided to do that. So you can see at the moment, active deals, none. It's going to wait for the right opportunity. Moment to buy in, okay? So when those signals have all been met, it will buy in. Okay, so that's basically trading bots. I'll leave you a link in the bottom if you want to get a discount on the 3commas account. But I think you can get you can run it with one bot or something like that for absolutely free, I think. So it's worth trying out. It's pretty easy to get going, you know, and basically by using bots, you can be having a sleep and the bot can be trading for you. Okay. So sounds like a good idea. You know, you're making money while you sleep. Who doesn't want to do that? Eh? Okay. So enjoy.